So friends, now we will learn what are the basic steps in the finite elements method. So the first steps, it will be discretizing the finite element model. So in the given problem, the body or the element may be given in the 3D model. It may be given in the solid object. Suppose if it is a bar element, the model will be, we have to convert that model, given model, into the line diagram or the element going to discretize. So in a line, so you have to represent the number like 1, 2, 3 nodes, and also you have to mention the deformation at each node, and also you have to apply the forces, means the force also you have to represent. So F1, F2, F3. So this step we called as discretizing the given model into an line diagram. So second step, you have to calculate the stiffness matrix for each element. So now you have to represent the element 1 and element 2. So this is 1, 9, 2. So you need to calculate the stiffness matrix for each element. Suppose there are two elements now, you have to calculate the stiffness matrix for K1 and K2. So individual stiffness matrix you have to calculate. Now the third step. After calculating the stiffness matrix for individual element, you have to calculate the global stiffness matrix. So global stiffness matrix is nothing but assembling of all the stiffness matrix, or the addition of all the stiffness matrix. Using the global stiffness matrix method, you have to add all the stiffness matrix, where K is equal to K1 plus K2 plus K3, or if you have another elements, you can add now. So using the methodology of the global stiffness matrix, you have to apply and you have to calculate the global stiffness matrix. And the fourth one, fourth step, it will be making the formation, formation of finite element equation. So you have to make the formation. So what is the formation? Where stiffness matrix is equal to force per unit area. So K is equal to force per unit area. Force per unit deformation, or where K U is equal to F. This is the finite element equation. K U is equal to F. Now the fifth one, after making the formation, you have to apply the boundary condition. Applying the boundary condition, so to know how to apply the boundary condition, I have made the videos on that. Just visit the video and just learn how to apply the boundary condition for the bar, beam and truss elements. So you have to calculate the boundary condition. You have to take the boundary condition. Suppose for the given problem, the boundary condition where U1, it will be 0. And the load if you applied here, so that is F2, it will be some loads. So that will be called as the boundary condition, or it is also called as the input values. Whatever the input value you are substituting to the given problem. So whatever that may be, temperature related, thermal related, and statical loads, dynamic loads, all these are will comes under the boundary conditions. So after applying the boundary condition, you need to calculate the displacements or deformation for unknown values. So now, where here in this particular case, U1 it will be 0. So U2, U3 you have to calculate. So that is the unknown displacement. U2, U3 are the displacement you have to calculate. So after calculating, the displacements or deformation, you need to calculate the stresses. Stresses for each element. So there are two elements, element 1 and element 2. So stresses is nothing but sigma 1. For the bar element, it is E by L minus 1, 1. So here displacement, that is U1 and u2. So this is the equation for the bar element. So using this equation, you have to calculate the stiffness matrix for element 1. So now if you are calculating for element 2, there will be sigma 2 e2 l2 here u2 u3. So based on that, you have to calculate the stiffness stresses for the individual element. So once you calculated the stresses, then the last step, it will be to calculate the reaction forces. Eighth one, calculating the reaction forces. Okay, for the given problem where the node 1 is fixed, it means there is a reaction force at node 1. It means R1 you have to calculate. Okay, so like that, these are the around 8 to 9 steps in the finite element method. You have to determine the first displacement, and you have to determine the stresses, and also you have to determine the reaction forces. So these are the basic steps in the finite elements method. So thank you for watching.